going on, fellas and ladies? I didn't forget about you. Long Cold, remember, watch us every Saturday, 7 o'clock. Shout out, Blue Subber, Jaime Hernandez. Alrighty, I think I got that right. Right, Jaime? You'll let me know. Alrighty, so right now what we're showing... Oh, wait a minute. Let me pause for station identification. Right now you're looking at Long Cold on the network Mighty Lawns. Watch us every Saturday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So right now we're just showing you that teaching is essential. We've been done with this property. It wasn't to my liking. I like for it to be perfect. When you're dealing with the state-sized properties, or even if they're not a state size, but they happen to be, and I know you guys are going to think this is weird, it happens to be an estate-styled home in a neighborhood, but they don't really have an estate-sized property, the clients can get very picky. But what you don't want to start doing, you don't want to treat clients different, okay? You want to treat your customers, no matter if it's your small yard or your big yard, treat them all the same, okay? And that's what I like to do. I like to treat every last one of our customers exactly the same. And so I'm very particular about how I do my my yards, how they're kept up. Blow that on high. Hey, what's going on, guys? Your host DK here. Hope you're enjoying this episode of Long Cold. These workers ain't loyal. So I had to show you these different clips. You know, I put them together because I wanted to show you how one person can absolutely try to ruin your business. And as you see the different workers that we've had in this short period of time, you're talking about 5 to 6 months in the beginning and almost to the end of this season. And, you know, one stablemate tried to ruin that, unbeknownst to me. You know, I knew that he needed a lot of work learning the lawn care industry, and I thought that he wanted to learn. But as I look at these clips and the information that Doug had given me, you know, what Ben was saying behind my back as far as, you know, not wanting to double cut, not wanting to blow the grass, I look back at these clips and now understand the other workers, their frustrations. You know, a little bit of, you know, history I can give you is that in the 5 to 6 months, every worker that I would get, especially when you're just you're just starting out, a lot of the workers, what they would do, and I thought it was about me, but what they would do, they would take equipment from Ben right there, as you see him. They would take the equipment from him and finish his jobs for him. A lot of the workers would, you know, get frustrated as well. And, you know, like I said before, I knew that he needed a lot of work as a worker, but I had no idea that pretty much he was playing me like a fiddle. As you see Ernesto over there, he was actually my third worker. He was my third worker who started out with us after the first guy quit, and then there was Ben. Ben was there for the total duration, or almost, because the season has about a month and a half left. I'll say a month. Got about a month left into the season. So that's my biggest tip to you newbies out there. You know, if you decide to start with someone other than yourself, make sure it's somebody who is trustworthy. Because a lot of these guys out here just want a paycheck. They just want something to help them get by. As you guys know, we're only out here Fridays and Saturdays, so I'm benefiting as the owner of the company, but these workers are not really benefiting. So it's understandable that they have to go out and get another job. Now, to other workers, one day's worth of work is not too bad, considering that they'll make more working with me in that one day than they would, you know, working at Burger King or mopping floors somewhere. Nothing against anybody who does that. You have to do what you have to do. But you see the, you know, point I'm trying to make. Another thing that Ben would do is that one customer in particular, you've heard this story before, but I'm going to go more in depth about it. What Ben would like to do is talk bad about this customer to the point where it was getting in his head. He said that this customer reminded him of someone who worked with him at a former company in the past and just couldn't stand the guy. He said he bragged too much and he hated going to this property. Some of the other things that Ben would do is I have a $20 referral program that I offer to all my employees. And so what Ben would do is he would feel as though if we're out cutting together, and when I say us, I mean, you know, myself as well, if a customer will walk up, he felt as though that $20 should go straight to him, not understanding that the $20 referral program was for the You know, for my people, my workers, if you go out and knock door to door and sign up customers that way, not if somebody walks up and the owner of the company is right there. It just doesn't make sense. And for all of you who think it makes sense to you, well, let me break it down. $20 goes to you if you go door to door and sign up a customer. You give them your business card. This is on your own, whether it be by yourself, with your kids, with your family, wife, doesn't matter. You're entitled to the $20. If the owner is with you on a property while you're doing a job, it doesn't make much sense to give someone $20 extra for something that they didn't find on their own. So that's pretty much how that was broken down. Another thing too that he loved doing was complaining. And that was one of the biggest things that I told him from the get-go. I said, listen, you know, I can't deal with people complaining. I can't deal with, you know, I can't attitude. So we have to fix that. And, you know, he said he would fix it. And that's where the miscommunication came in with Doug. You know, when Doug at the time had only worked with me for about a couple of days, by the second day he was already complaining. But come to find out, he was complaining because he was doing all the work and Ben wasn't shouldering anything, wasn't shouldering any of the load. And so that's why, you know, when you guys are doing your business out there, you got to talk to your workers. Every individual worker, excuse me, don't just talk to one worker and feel that they're the voice. And I don't care how long they've been with you. Don't, you know, you have to talk to everyone. And knowing that this is your baby, this business here, this is your baby. This is your face on it. The customers, they want to see you. All right? This business should mean everything to you. And when you have a cancer like that, what do you got to do? You got to remove it. Now, I've lost tons of workers. I don't know if I have all the clips here, but I feel like I've had at least about 10 to 12 workers in a 5-month span. That's saying a lot. And to me, you would think, well, it's got to be the owner. It's the owner's fault. Well, like I said, when you get information like this, you're like, oh, okay, so one of my so-called loyal workers was poisoning everybody to the point where they didn't want to work. They didn't want to work. So you got to figure out, when you see that there's an issue going on, you got to figure out what's causing that issue. All right? And you got to hit it right in the head. So I hope you guys are enjoying this episode of Long Code. It's kind of like a special edition. Kind of put this together about a couple of weeks ago and just had it sitting in queue waiting to upload today. All right? So until next time, remember, check out Long Code every Saturday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Also, check out the new show. Well, it's not really new anymore, but check it out every Monday at, I guess I got those times confused. The Mighty Loans Network airs Mondays at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Long Code airs every Saturday, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So hope you guys got that. Long Code, 7 o'clock on Saturdays in the p.m. And the new Lawn Care News channel, Mighty Lawns Network, it airs every Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So enjoy this episode. Remember, like and subscribe to us. Follow us on Twitter. Also, like us on Facebook as well. Facebook.com/MightyLawns. And also, you know what to do. Hit the red tab and sub to us below. As you look at that clip there, look at him having fun. Now, what he told Doug was, he hates the job. He doesn't like to do lawn care, but he seems like he's having fun right there. You guys be the judge. Until next time.
Turbo XTS from Cadillac, 410 available horses, room for four, twice the fun.
Welcome back, guys. Long Code, watch it, every one of them. Remember, like and subscribe to us below. Your host DK here. I'm gonna show you this property. Gotta trim these bushes here. let's get right into it. Hey y'all, you know we had to do this breaking news, which you're going to see throughout all of these various long cold shows. Listen, hope you've been enjoying this episode and enjoying the new show, Mighty Lawns Network. But what I want to talk to you newbies about is doing a great job when you go out to your customers' properties and not calling, you know, at least in front of the customers, not calling it a yard, giving the customer and the yard its respect by calling it the property. Well, what do I mean, you ask? Well, anytime you're referencing someone's home and you're out doing a landscaping job or a lawn job, lawn maintenance, you want to always refer to it as the property. You know, hey, you know, Mighty Lawns enjoys maintaining the upkeep of your property. You want to always seem professional. Always be professional at all times, no matter what. I believe you've seen clips on Lawn Code where me interacting with other companies. You guys know what I'm talking about. And so you always want to be professional. Never be the guy who's unprofessional, because people are watching you. Trust me when I tell you, someone's always watching. And so you always must be professional at all times. So right now we're going to take you into a little advice, some tips from our buddy Asim from Asim Landscaping. So enjoy.
Asim members again from Asim Landscaping, back at you here. We're going to do some more pruning with our gardenia. Now, gardenias are pretty much a real bolstering type of shrub. Right now, we have one that's pushing about 4.5 feet, possibly. It's pretty full. It's got a little uneven growth going on to it. It hasn't yet budded yet. It's the fall of the year. So we want to try and get this guy pruned back so it can go ahead, go into the fall of the year. It's going to be green all year, you know, for the fall of the year, going into the spring, where it's going to bud back out again. Well, when it does bud, we want it to be prepared, because we're going to prune it back so it can come back full. So what we're going to do, we're going to give it some shape, just as we did with the boxwood before, but we're going to make sure that we even it off so that it has a real nice texture to it, as well as some good form up against the house. As you can see, didn't take long, less than 5 minutes. Shaped, nice, pretty even. I gave it a little contouring for the top, because the center's kind of full, but we made sure we gave it some form, kind of a wine glass effect, So it sits up really good up against the house. Also, it's been set and ready for the fall.
Winter comes in,
still gonna be green. Spring comes full, then we're gonna start getting some nice white blooms as seen here on this particular gardenia. Still needs to be pruned back. As I said, six foot foliage here, but it can be pruned back to look just like this.
Remember, every Saturday at 7 p.m., check out Lawn Code. Also, check out the video of this property and how we did a great lawn renovation. I mean, the work is there, loading the bricks up, working the smart way. Remember below, like and subscribe to it. Gotta go super hard today, man. So as you see there, these are all the spots where we're putting the bricks. Right down there. And we're gonna make sure that we go one level in the front. Pretty much you wanna get it to look like you see there. And so we just created this one. There was no pavers here at all. Remember, once again, like and subscribe to us below. We want to thank all of our subbers. Check us out tonight at 7 o'clock. And so we're laying all the pavers down, making sure they're nice and straight. Hey guys, welcome to Lawn Code. Your host DK here. New reality show promo that we're doing. We're just showing you how we get out in the morning, take everything out, gas it all up. Probably we got 2 yards that we have to do. This one, and then this one over here. So we're just taking everything out. We're gonna go say hello to the folks, Ben. Ben, right there.
That's mine.
That's mine. That's mine.
Come on, Carl.
It's mine, Kyle.
Revenge is best served with 272 horses. Get the best offers of the season now. Lease's 2014 ATS for around $299 a month with premium care maintenance included.
All right, guys. So when I wasn't looking, this is just when you think you know a person. When I wasn't looking, I'm slapping invoices on doors now. But when I wasn't looking, Ben was taking himself a little nice long little break. Now, mind you, he knows that he's quick no matter what. Even if he doesn't get the job, he knows that, you know what, today's my last day. He doesn't care about humping along. I thought he did at first, but I'm the denominator. I was standing right there. So, you just gotta watch. I think somebody uploaded, I wanna say his channel's 405 Tuners. I might have that wrong. Wow, coming to get me. Oh shoot, why am I always getting into it with something or somebody every week? Oh my god. But you know, he taking him a little long break and knows that we got a hump today. And so I'm just like wow, like let's hump along, you know, let's get it going. So you kind of find out how a person really is, I guess, when their days are numbered, when they're like, yeah, I quit. You know, just taking them a nice little break. I figured maybe the mower stopped. So I asked him, I said, stop working? Nah. That was his response. Look at that family. He said, nah, you know. So it's kind of being a little cocky. I'm noticing as the day progressing, progresses, he's being a little cocky. That's cool, you know. I don't know why you would, well, you didn't have, you know, any job opportunities. Modern Lawns gave you the opportunity, so I don't know what's the point of being cocky. I mean, we're proud, and, you know, but I think that's how problems start, you know, because we'll get all cocky and, oh, I don't need you no more. You know, I had one worker early on in the season who did me like that. Showed up to his house one morning and he just was like, no, I ain't coming out. I got a full-time job now. I'm like, wow, you know, we talked about this the night before. You know, about your schedule. So some people you find out they're real characters when they get something else. So it is what it is. I don't know if you call that advice or a tip, but it is what it is. So we'll see you next time. All right. So what's going on now is that I had a worker, of course, who's quitting today. And then underneath, because he got to come back and weed eat. So pretty much what's going on today. So you might as well, because he got to trim that, so you might as well get your blower ready. Then let me see what she got under here. See if you can get back to it. Once again, like and subscribe to us below. Okay. Shout out to all of our subbers. We really appreciate you. And if you can't, I don't know if you have to do it on hands and knees. This is what she's talking about. That little crap under there. And then all these and these rocks too. Thank you, Doug. So pretty much we've been talking about. But now it seems to be sweet. We have Ben, longtime Mighty Lawns representative, who quit today. But he's going to finish out his day. Proper and professional thing to do. We welcome Doug back to the Mighty Lawns team. Because, you know, we feel like we can work with anybody. And I have a big heart and I believe in second chances. So, getting to this property, decides, and I can see his attitude has changed. Like, hey, I don't need this crap job no more. You know, I got me a full-time gig now. Hey, no problem. So we get to the property. He's letting Doug, mind you, we're at a property that's townhomes. Very small strip of grass, as you can see. So if you see the back, the front is even smaller, which I can show you that. Ben decides what areas he should trim and weed eat, right? This is all in the mind frame of somebody who just said, man, I quit. Why do I have to continue to show people how to do this job? He let him weed eat all over here. This is a different property I'm showing you, YouTubers, my mo bros. Okay, so this is a totally different property. He let Doug weed eat all of you. This property has a different lawn care company. So once again, if you saw Lawn Coat last week, I told a rival, listen, I'm not doing your work for you. Now, take it back to today. If Doug is weed eating this other property, then shouldn't I send a bill to someone? But I can't, because it's my fault. Because I should, as the owner, I should have got up and showed him. So let's take a look at this property. It didn't take long to really cut. Technically, or really, 5 to 10 minutes. There's the front. I don't know. That big shrub there is the marker. Or you could say this tree is the marker. That mailbox is the marker. Show me, upload a video of her property that you have that's smaller than this. Could y'all do that for me? So this is what you call a disgruntled employee. He didn't care that, and he shouldn't be disgruntled. He's the one who quit on me. I didn't quit on him. A person who doesn't give a crap. Who's just like, eh? I'll let him keep going. I'll waste more time. But guess what? We got some things we got to do. Hey, until next time, like us, subscribe to us. All of our subbers out their channels. Please do. Yes, I'm forgetting somebody. Shout out Cut Grass and Lawn Care Company. Shout out Pro Lawn Care 1-to-1. I'm still forgetting somebody. But it's because it was last night. See, Breezy. All right, so I had this property, awesome property. This is the customer that it want to pay the $400 charge to go get 50 bales of pine straw at $3.69 from Home Depot. They didn't want to get it. I want to touch on this first though. When you have crap like this on the concrete, get rid of it with your weed eater, okay? Once again, y'all sub down there and comment and let me know what you would have charged. So check this out. On this part, I was going to dig all this up, put weed block underneath, pine straw. There. Right? Okay. See that tree over there? Pine straw. All around the house, pine straw. This area here, trim the bushes up. Pine straw underneath, of course, weed blocker as well. Here. Get closer. They're going to have to blow this crap. All right. All in here to do it the right way. All in here. Pine straw. Okay. All over there. Don't let me get ahead of myself. I guess I could have walked all the way around. But all over here, pine straw. Shout out to Patrick Wheatley. Y'all support that young kid, man. I think some other channel told him, I don't need you subbing to me or something to that regard, because you don't have enough subbers. Excuse me. All right, so pine straw all around the base of this house. Okay. Pine straw on this. Okay. Pine straw. All right. Pine straw on that tree back there. Pine straw once again all around the house. Okay. Keep this in simple. You're out there. You're creators, man. This ain't just, even though some jobs seem to be exactly the same, you're creating something, man. You're creating something that people can tell their family about. You know? Charge for that. Charge for your creativity, man. Don't be scared. Says, what's up, Fusco Lawn Care? What's going on, man? Like he said, man, if they don't like your price, so what? And that's the truth. They're not going to like it. And then right there, pine straw. And right here. And once again, all this grass and the and these cracks, kill it. Kill it with your weed eater and then come back with some spray so it doesn't come back. So there you have it. Did I charge appropriately? You know? Comment below, man. I want to know what y'all think, man. Stop viewing my videos and not comment, man. I do want y'all to comment, though. So let me know, was I wrong? How much would y'all charge? All right? Let me know. Let me know if I charge too much for a person who drive a Mercedes GL and a S-Class. Y'all let me know, man. Maybe I'm in the wrong. Maybe I'm not. You know. And let's subtract the Benzes that they drive. Maybe I'm just in the wrong. Maybe I should have bought the pine straw myself. You know, spent anywhere from, depending on the bales, all this money on the pine straw. 50 at $3.69. Y'all can add it up and do the math. You know what I'm saying, something dollars, 180 something. Okay? Should I have just installed it for $20? Wow. If you guys said yes, you do not need to be in the business. I hope none of you said yes. Alright. Watch Lawn Code every Saturday. I feel like doing like a Frank Sinatra type of song right now. All right, until we meet again, let me get back to it, man, for somebody else commenting and say I suck as a business owner and I suck because I don't get my fat, lazy butt and I don't do no work. They don't even think as a business owner when you're thinking mentally, they don't think that that's work. Scrubs, man. Step your game up, guys. Nah, we want to blow it this way. I don't want it on their property. Oh, you got it. Come on. So right now, you can see what we're doing. Blowing under the deck. I don't want any other grass seeds, weed seeds. I don't want none of that crap going to this property. Step your game up. Mo Bros. I dare you. Perfect. I dare you to do this right now.
Goodbye, gray sky, hello blue. This nothing can hold me when I hold you. It feels so right, it can't be wrong. Rockin' and rollin' all week long.